izzet Allah. Nahmeduhu, we praise him. Ve nasta'inuhu, and we look for his assistance and his help. Ve nasta'dihi, we look for also his guidance. Ve nasta'firuhu, we look for his forgiveness. Ve na'uzu billahi min shurur anfusina, we look for refuge in Allah against the evil of our souls. Ve min sayyi'ati a'malina, and the wickedness of our action. Man yahdi Allah fa huwa al-muhtadi, whoever Allah has guided, he is among, or she is among, the elected ones. وَمَنْ يُدْلِلْ فَلَا هَالِيَ لَهُ, and whoever Allah has misguided, there is no one who can guide him, never himself, nor someone else. أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ, I testify that there is no God but Allah worthy to be worshipped. وَأَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ, and I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is Allah's messenger. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Oh, you who believe, fear Allah the way He deserves to be feared, and don't accept to die, to be surprised by the death, unless you are completely, absolutely, perfectly submit to Allah. Ya ayyuhan nasu taqu rabbakum alladhi khalaqakum min nafsin wahida wa khalaqa minha zawjaha وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. Oh, mankind, fear your Lord who has created you and originated you from one single soul and has put with him his companion, female companion, female mate. And he has created and spread many men and women. Fear Allah, to whose name you are asking one another favors, benefits, bounties, forgiveness, so on and so on. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَالْأَرْحَامَ الَّذِي تَسَعَلُوا يَوْا الْأَرْحَامِ, and also fear to break your blood ties, your parenthood, your brotherhood, the natural biological brotherhood, don't break it. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا, indeed Allah is watching you. Whenever He commands you to do something, He knows if you are doing for His sake or if you don't do it. This is very important to be understood and to be apprehended. Then you have to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you every day, every hour and every minute. He's not far from you. He is very close to you. He knows you. He accompanies you everywhere and whenever. Then this is very important. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا. This ayah must be embedded in your soul all the time. Al-Muraqaba, you have to know, I'm with Allah always. I cannot separate myself from Him. I cannot be far from Him. I am with Him whenever, everywhere. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu attaqullaha wa qulu qawlan sadida yuslih lakum a'malakum wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum wa man yut'i Allaha wa rasulahu faqad faza fawzan 'azima. Oh, you who believe, fear Allah and tell only the truth. If you fear Allah and you tell the truth, Allah will put you in among those for whom he has forgiven. And also Allah will perfect, will accomplish your action, all the action you are about to do. This is so important. وَمَنْ يَتِعِ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ. And whoever obeys Allah and Messenger, he will be successful in everything. أَمَّا بَعْدُ فَإِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. After all that, you know, before you begin your speech, in Islam, it is recommended very strongly to begin by praising Allah. Praising Allah is one of the invocations that Allah likes. تَحْمِدُ اللَّهُ من الأذكار الطيبة المقبولة التي يرفع الله بها صاحبها ما لزم أحد الذكر بتحميد الله وتسبيحه وتكبيره وتحليله والحول لا إلا رفعه الله سبحانه وتعالى في الدنيا وأخرى. Whoever is accustomed, who is used to invoke Allah through his glorification, his praising, his magnificence, no doubt that Allah will increase him every day, until he reaches his final destination, which is paradise, inshallah ta'ala. Our final destination, inshallah, is paradise, the proximity of with Allah. Then, فَإِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. The best and the most important speech is the divine one, Kitabullah. Kitabullah huwa asdaqul hadith. Asdaqul hadith Kitabullah. Wa asdaqu ash-shay ma zakarahu Allah fi kitabihi. The truest thing, the most authentic thing, speech you can ever know, discover, is the divine one. If you read the Quran, the Torah, the Gospel, if they are not altered, manipulated, you will be happy because you will never see in it something which can hurt your intelligence, which can hurt your sound and authentic way to understand the universe and what the universe contains. As-salamu alaykum. As-salamu alaykum. As-salamu alaykum. Then وَخَيْرَ الْهَدِيهَا مُحَمَّدٍ. If the best interpretation of the Qur'an is the one done by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, Muhammad has interpreted the Qur'an. He has brought to us the interpretation of the Qur'an. This is called a sunnah. Huh? Because we will see inshallah during our speech that there are many, many interpretations of the Qur'an. All the deviation you see in the past or today, there are two interpretations. وَقَالَ الْحَدِيثُ مُحَمَّدٍ وَشَرَّ الْأُمُورُ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا. And the worst things are the matters which are new in religion, in Islam. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. And every new matter in Islam, introduced in Islam by people without the inspiration of Allah, it is called al-bid'ah. Wa kulla bid'atin dalala. And every single innovation is a misguidance. Wa kulla dalalatin fi an-nar. And every misguidance is destined to hellfire. This is very important. This is the speech the Prophet ﷺ wants to deliver when he wants to talk. And he has done it before even he immigrated to Al-Madina. There was an Arab, a Bedouin from Yemen, Imam ibn Sa'laba. He came to Mecca before the immigration of the Prophet ﷺ to Al-Madina. He met him. He was a poet at the same time. He was a medical doctor. The way to say it very easily. He came to Muhammad and told him, "Oh Muhammad, I heard that you are attacked by jinn and I cure people from this kind of illness. Then can you come to to benefit from me. And Muhammad asked him, have you finished? He said, exactly, I have finished. And he told him, إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نَحْمَدُهُ وَنَسْتَعِينُهُ وَنَسْتَغْفِرُهُ وَنَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ So on. You see, and before even he immigrated to Al-Madinah, he was using to use this introduction. It is very important because in it, you have all the aspects of Al-Tawheed. And Al-Tawheed, all the aspects of Al-Tawheed are mentioned in this speech. إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نَحْمَدُهُ وَنَسْتَعِينُهُ وَنَسْتَغْفِرُهُ وَنَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ Sometimes there are many, many words, sometimes there are only one or two words. نَحْمَدُهُ وَنَسْتَعِينُهُ وَنَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنْفُسِنَا Then you are, by telling this speech, you are trying to establish all the foundation, the structure, the architecture of al-Aqidah. Then how Allah is, and how He can be close to us, and how, who am I, and what I can do as a servant of Allah. Then if I am a believer, this is my duty, or this is the package of my duties. I have to do all my best to accomplish and to perform them. It's okay? Alhamdulillah, we have promised you to talk about Al-Imam Al-Muhammad bin Ismail bin Ibrahim bin Mughira. Alhamdulillah, you know, Alhamdulillah, we have not enough time, but we will do our best to summarize his life. And Muhammad ibn Ismail, ibn Ibrahim, ibn Al-Mughira. If you want, you tell Muhammad ibn Ismail ibn Ismail ibn Ibrahim ibn Al-Mughira. This is the best way to tell it. He was born in 194 Al-Hijri.
Can I have some? A marker.
He was born in 194 Al-Hijri.
Voilà.
Then this is the second century of Al-Islam. Second century of Al-Islam. This is the second century of Islam. 194. The last Sahaba passed away 109107. The last Sahab. That the time of Al-Tabi'un begins after the death of the Prophet. It's okay? The time. No.
Repeat.
قلت هو قد ولد في سنة 194. القرن الأول ينتهي في هذه السنة سنة لأن آخر الصحابة موتا
قد توفي في هذه السنة. The last Sahaba to die was in 107. Who knows his name here? آخر الصحابة موتا. Who is he?
107.
Huh?
107.
Huh?
Name.
The name. People are discussing about three people. Anas bin Malik. Anas bin Malik, some people think he was the last Sahaba to die. But we specify, it is according towns. The last Sahaba to die in Madinah, Al-Madinah. The last Sahaba to die in Mecca, in Al-Basra, in Al-Iraq. This is the way they use it, okay? Then this is more specific and more strong. Then we can consider Anas bin Malik in Al-Basra, Basura, as the last Sahaba to die, 107. But the time of the companions has finished with him. At the same time, at Tabi'un, their life has begun after the death of the Prophet. When the Prophet passed away, Hijrah, Salatu Ashrin min al-Hijrah.
The Tabi'un starts after the last Sahaba died?
No. After, because they are with the Sahaba. But we didn't meet the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
No.
You see, then among even the grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like Ummu Kulthum, Hussein has seen him. Mm-hmm. Hussein has seen him. Hassan has seen him. But many,
Muhammad
many,
Muhammad bin Abu Bakr.
He didn't. Yes, Muhammad bin Abu Bakr, the son of Abu Bakr, didn't see the Prophet. He passed away before his birth. And many other, all the companions who were young and who weren't married, they have made many children. The vast majority of them were like that. Then their children didn't meet the Prophet and they didn't see him. It's okay? Many of them. Urwat ibn Zubair, he didn't see the Prophet. But he is the son of Az-Zubair ibn al-Awwam. Sa'id ibn al-Musayyab, he didn't see the Prophet, but he is the son of al-Musayyab, who was a companion, and his father also was a companion. Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr, he didn't see him. Many. And the last children of Abu Bakr, the last children of Ali, because Ali has given to us 29 children. Only Al-Hassan, Al-Hussein have seen the Prophet. Then all the kids of Ali, they are companion, a tabi'in, but they didn't see the Prophet. It's okay. Then many of the companions have met the tabi'un. But historically, we consider the time of tabi'un from the death of the Prophet until the death of the last person among the time who has seen the last companion of the Prophet. It's okay? The last person who has seen the last companion of the Prophet among the Tabi'in, he is the last of the Tabi'in. Then they take historically from, this is the Al-Qarn Al-Awwal 101 and Al-Qarn Al-Sani 201. Then Al-Bukhari, he was born in the second century, 194. But he passed away in the third century. He passed away in 256. Then how many years has he lived?
63.
It's okay. Then he didn't live a long time. He is he among the companions of the Prophet?
No.
At-Tabi'un?
No.
At-Tabi'ut-Tabi'in?
No.
Tabi'ut-Tabi'it-Tabi'in?
Yes.
No.
No.
Yes. Four generation or six generation?
Al-Bukhari. No, third generation. 194. Like, if you see...
Chronologically, he's third generation.
Yes, what you give here.
Yes, but if you...
194.
Yes.
Like, you try to put 194.
Yes.
Put it here. Like, no, like here.
Yes.
107. 194 should be here, around here.
Yes. Thank you.
Yeah, this is 194 now.
194.
Now this is the generation of Bukhari. It's right here.
You see, alhamdulillah. You're right. Then the generation al-Bukhari, he was born in the second century, but he passed away in
third century.
Yeah. Thank you so much, my brother. That this is very important to be known. That during this period of time, people have withdrew Islam. Why? Because al-fitan lam tadhhar wa in dhaharat fahiya maghluba. The discord wasn't born. Even if it was born, it wasn't strong. It's okay? This is very important. Al-fitna lam tadhhar wa in dhaharat falesat qawiyya. The discord wasn't born. But even if it was born, it wasn't strong. Then al-Bukhari, he came during that time of period of history. Then he was born in 194 and he passed away to 56. But where he was born, this is very important. He was born in a place called Uzbekistan. Today it is Uzbekistan. Who have a world map? Yes.
No, we don't have it here, but
yes.
You can Google it.
Who can Google it very easily? This is America.
Afghanistan. Yeah, that's the
idea. America. Asia.
Since 92.
Europe.
Since 92, they have
their own. Africa. That this part of Asia is called Central Asia. And we have many, many countries. Oh, Barakallah.
They cannot make
yes.
But Israel here,
Uzbekistan. Turkmenistan,
Tajikistan,
Kyrgyzstan,
Iran,
Afghanistan,
Iran.
In the south, Uzbekistan in the north.
Down, you will have Kuwait, Bahrain,
very, very, very.
The person goes.
Yes. Then this is Uzbekistan. And in Uzbekistan, we have many, many cities. You can take Uzbekistan.
Yes.
Many cities. Uzbekistan, before at that time, was belonging to some part called Al-Khorasan. It's okay? Mm-hmm. All the people coming here from Iran, Afghanistan, and in the land, which is the country. And this is Uzbekistan, the country of Uzbek. You see it? Afghanistan, the country of Afghan. Pakistan, the country of Pakistan. An means country. Then Uzbekistan is the country of
Uzbek.
The Uzbek. Then who was al-Bukhari? He was an Uzbek. He was Uzbek. But Uzbek, they are not like Arabs. They are not like we black. They are called Indo-European. It's okay? Then the people of Europe, the Caucasian, they come from this one. They come from here. For India, from Afghanistan, Turkmenistan, Kyrgyzstan. They emigrated from here to Europe, and from Europe to America. It's okay? Mm-hmm. Then Al-Bukhari come here. He came from this country. It is an independent country today since 1991, because it was a part of Soviet Union. After the dislocation and the collapse of Soviet Union, many countries, which he has mentioned, took their independence. Among them, Uzbekistan. And Uzbekistan, you have many, many important cities. One of them, Bukhara. This is one of the big cities. Another city, Tirmiz.
And Samarkand.
Samarkand. Marwa. Then many ulama, many scholars have been born here. Many scholars have been born here. At-Tirmizi, do you know At-Tirmizi?
No.
He's from Tirmiz. Between Bukhara and Tirmiz, there are only 100 kilometers. Then from the town of Al-Bukhari to the town of At-Tirmizi, there is only 100 kilometers. And we have also Marwa, Marwazi. One of the best students of Imam Ahmad, Al-Marwazi. He's from here, Marwa. Samarkand, we have a big scholar whose name is Abu Al-Lays Al-Samarkandi. You see, but all of them, people are used to call them Al-Khurasaniyun. That Ishaq ibn Rahuwayhi from here, Al-Bukhari from here, Al-Ghazali from here, Al-Imam, Imam al-Haramain al-Juwayni from here, Abu Hanifata from the south here, Afghanistan, Muslimun from here, all these scholars, they are from here. You see, then this is very important to be known. Al-Bukhari, Muslimun, Al-Nisa'i, Al-Tirmizi, Ibn Majah, Abu Hanifata, Al-Marwazi, Rahway, all of them, they have been born here.
That means Bukhari is not then a name, it's a place.
It is a place. His name is Muhammad ibn Ismail ibn Ibrahim ibn Al-Mughira. Then when Islam came here, from here, in what country? Barakallah, Al-Hijaz. It is not Saudi Arabia. This is not true. Saudi Arabia has been founded when?
Recently.
Very recently.
200 years ago.
No. 1932. Alf, I mean, was someone, Tismi, I think, was, his name was Salasin. L'Arabie Saoudite a été créée seulement en 1932. Donc il ne faut pas dire que Mohammed vient de l'Arabie Saoudite. Donc Mohammed is from Saudi Arabia. The king who has founded it, his name is
Saud.
Abdul Aziz ibn Saud. He passed away when? Il a créé le royaume. He has created it in 1932 and he passed away 1953. 19 years after his death. His son, Saud, became the king, but he couldn't continue, and he was replaced by Faisal. After Faisal, Khalid. After Khalid, Fahd. After Fahd, Abdullah. After Abdullah, Salman. Then we have begun very recently. There wasn't Saudi Arabia. It has begun only in 1932. True or false? Alhamdulillah. Then this is very important. Then Al-Hijaz, Islam has begun in two countries, in two cities, only two cities. Where? Mecca and Al-Madina. Intah. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has lived only in two cities, all in two cities. He has spent 62 years in between. Then he didn't know anything about Uzbekistan, Kyrgyzstan, Turkmenistan. He didn't know that. ولكن قال الله سبحانه وتعالى إذا جاء نصر الله الفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلوا في دين الأفواج then الناس هؤلاء
from Uzbekistan
هؤلاء هم الناس then they became Muslim after the conquest of this part Khorasan. All this is called Al-Khorasan. Uzbekistan, Iran, Afghanistan. When Iran took the name Iran, when? 1933, it was called only Farisu. But in 1932, they took this name Iran. Now, before that, it was called Farisu. Then Farisu, Khorasan, هذه الأراضي كلها كانت غير مسلمة. Then Imam al-Bukhari, Muhammad bin Ismail, Muhammad bin Ibrahim al-Mughira, he was born here. When Islam has reached here, it's okay. When he was born, the Muslim Ummah was unified around one Khalifa, who was in Baghdad, here, Iraq. The Khalifa was here, and Al-Abbasiyyin هم الذين كانوا الخلفاء. He was born when the Khalifa was in Baghdad. Who has created Baghdad? Who has founded Baghdad? Someone bears his name here in the mosque. Only one person bears his name, and he is in this mosque. Abu Ja'far al-Mansur. Then the founder of Baghdad, his name is Abu Ja'far al-Mansur. He was the great of Ibn Abbas. Abdullah ibn Abbas, his great son, has founded Baghdad. Then he was with his grandfather, his father, for 8 centuries we have ruled Islam. 8 centuries we have ruled Islam. Then during that time, Al-Bukhari was born. He didn't know anything about Arabic language because he didn't